and welcome to the stream. We are going to be doing the Curse of Monkey Island, being a cross-suffering tale of adventure, but with more puzzles. Yes, we're going to be doing Mega Monkey, because I like to do things hard. Well, no, not actually, but it's more interesting. Hello, empty stream room! Oh, you're out there? I can hear you leaving. I apologize for the joke. This is Monkey Island. The monkeys are listening. Yes, they are. I love the opening to this game. Reminds me of, well, the first time I played the Monkey Island game. Join our hero, Guybrush?
Captain's log. Guybrush Threepwood. Lost the crew for days now. I have no crew or navigational instruments.
You have the stars.
No provisions except a half-eaten corn dog, and yeah. Unless I find water soon, I'm surely done for.
You could convert
the hope of finding my love, and keeps me going. And on my quest for the fabulous treasure called Big Whoopers left me in this sad state. I thought it would bring me fame and glory. Instead, it delivered me into the clutches of my enemy, a zombie pirate like Chuck.
So that's sometimes bad.
I swore we'd leave a plot to Mary Elaine, and he was after revenge. Really, really thirsty now. If only I could have a small drink of fresh water, I might have the strength to sail on.
With what sail?
Oh, but I know there's nothing but ocean for miles and miles. If I could reach land, I might find water and some food. Food, maybe. Something to fight off the scurvy and help me get my strength to
carry it.
Maybe some bananas. Oh, why do I torture myself like this?
Torture is fun.
A big mug of grog for all the good it'll do me.
Gyro?
Oh, my sweet Elaine. Am I cursed to starve here on this ocean?
Yeah.
Without seeing your face?
It's a very cursed game.
Am I?
Are you completely oblivious to your surroundings? Yes, you are, Gyro. The Curse of Monkey Island. The first game that Ron Gilbert had nothing to do with. And I think it's a rather good entry. I don't think it falls prey to some of the problems the state of even Tales of Monkey Island falls prey to. This is obviously a labor of love for the people that produced this. But they weren't fanboying to a point of not being able to come up with new ideas. So as a disclaimer, I have to say that I have not played all the way through Tales. Didn't like my computer. It seriously did not like my computer. Well, I mean, it gets very dark in points, I've been told. I mean, I've been told it's a good entry into the series, but I just couldn't give most of it for the first valid time. If they ever port it to Xbox Live, I will, or Xbox Arcade, that is, I will give it another chance. Also, I like this game for the animation style. There's just something about it. I think this is why I like the reboot they did of Secret of Monkey Island and the Cuck's Revenge, the second Monkey Island game. Well, because it captures the same sort of animation style. And has the same voice actor.
I just don't feel that way about you.
Please, one more. Hello. That role is already
filled. I can't. I'm washing my hair tonight.
You're a pirate. Why are you washing your hair? That's code for you're never going to be in my pants. What are you looking for in a romantic relationship right now? She means she will never date you ever.
You're a bloodthirsty monster who's already kidnapped me once, tortured my friends, and taken from me the only man I've ever loved.
You're saying that in public?
How romantic.
Seriously, why did you just admit that in public alone?
Ship ahoy!
That kind of ship. That's a bumper car. Exploding.
Get him out.
You didn't even like that train.
Skybox?
Throw
him in a hole and I'll
finish him after the battle.
Famous last words.
Turn loose the longboat.
Voodoo Cannonball. Voodoo Cannonball? That doesn't sound good. Part 1, the demise of the zombie pirate the sex. Well, just give away the whole ending, will you? Huh. The short guy looks familiar.
Yeah, I
have
to get out of here.
How many gingers can you go in each year?
I could only get through this one door. And I could easily overpower the armed guards above.
But you said
over the side and make for the door.
Quit your mumbling, captive!
And then you can hold your breath for 5 minutes, by rest with that plan to see them. Hello, Wally. Small pilot, I mean. He is not Wally.
I don't think I've ever seen a cuter pilot.
Blast you, scurvy dog!
Plus,
if I rough him up, he may shoot him.
Yeah, I don't believe you shoot me.
Stay away!
I'm telling you, fine leather jacket.
Classic line.
No, I'm lying.
In that case, I don't want one.
Sorry, we couldn't make a deal.
Cross me again, and I'll come for shots with you.
So you got that line backwards. By the way, I'm telling you, fine leather jacket is a line from the Indiana Jones game. Oh, classic. Let's see, we want to go with some sound pretty tough and wearing a fake beard. Is that hook for real? Is that a real icon? Oh, boy, you can for a second or it's a slow pump. Personally, I like, is that hook for real? Or are you wearing a fake beard? Final ways for long distance shot, take time in. I don't know. Are you wearing a fake beard?
Are you wearing a fake beard?
Bloodnose, the pirate, would not have a fake beard.
Yes, he would. Yes, it is. It's been glued to your ear hair.
Actually, it's a highly sophisticated beard weave, made from the chest and back hair of real pirates.
Ew.
I'm hoping it'll take weeks if I don't wash it for a while.
Ew. Mm-hmm. And I just spoke space
pirate. Whoa! Don't you recognize me? It's Guybrush Threepwood.
Oh, I know I'm animated completely different and my legs are longer, but...
The last time I saw you, we were prisoners in the Chuck's dungeon.
How's
Why did you design armor to strip of the living dead?
Well, Mr. Brush, at first I had some misgivings about it.
Some?
But thanks to the Chuck's seminars, motivational lectures, and audio books on pirates, I've become a vicious course.
I don't want to know how that works.
You can too. Ask me how.
I will not. I will ask if there's any literature I can look at.
Do you have any literature I can look at?
Yeah.
You never know. It is the Caribbean.
Explains the basic philosophy.
I've been in the toilet for a while.
I'm not in the mood for sail time.
Let me free, Wally.
I can't, Mr. Brass.
Thank you,
sir. I'm the evil pirate Bloodnose now.
No,
you're right. Even if you got up on deck, the chuck would cut to the ribbon.
Well, let's find that
door.
Let's
find that door.
Ooh, that's the door to the Chuck's treasure hole. Mm-hmm. Heaps and piles of gold and silver. Mm-hmm. He's got all the loot he's ever stolen to give to Elaine. The Chuck is convinced that he can buy Elaine's love.
Mm. Well, she is a pirate.
What are the Chuck's plans?
He's been working on a secret weapon. An incredibly powerful cannonball. He's going to use it to blow down the walls of the fort so his crew can overrun the island.
Interesting plan. I don't think that would do anything.
The sailor is a pirate.
Shut the trap, you yellow-bellied bloaters. One more peep out of you, and I'll do you in.
Let's go with the pettiness.
Please.
Just stubborn swab. One more word and I'll let you have it.
Word.
That's it. I'm gonna blast you.
You're gonna what? That's what I thought.
Oh, I can't do it.
Of course you can.
Can't.
The father's son.
I'm just not a pirate. I'm not ferocious or bloodthirsty or hateful or anything.
You're adorable.
I'm not even unpleasant.
Poor guy. You made him cry. That's still his past the chuck.
I don't think I've ever seen a cuter pirate.
He is adorable.
I don't want to disturb him.
He's had a hard day.
He has. Most of the years have. Pick up that ramrod. I always wondered how he kept things in his hands. Let's play with the cannon. Excuse me. Still getting over a cold. The way this basically works is we shoot them. We make many things if we don't hit them.
What were you shooting?
I refuse to. The side of justice. We have to put yourself back together. I know, uncanny, isn't it? One more to go. All done.
I'm getting pretty good at this.
Yes, you are.
Look, all the bones and stuff are floating towards the ship.
Let's look at all them.
I can't quite squeeze past this thing.
Your lips aren't that big.
It's
Murray! Murray the fucking skull, Ava of Murray.
It's a horrible skull.
I know.
I think it would bite me.
Probably.
Ah, well. I guess I'll just have to look on the bright side of this.
What's the bright side of this?
At least I've lost some weight.
Yeah.
Boy, there's not much to do out here when you're just a bodiless head.
Let's talk to him.
Can I call you Bob?
You may call me Murray.
Murray!
I'm a powerful demonic force.
No, he's not.
I'm the harbinger of your doom.
He's really not.
And the forces of darkness will applaud me as I stride to the gates of hell, carrying your head on a pike.
Stride?
Yeah.
All right, then roll. Roll through the gates of hell. Must you take the fun out of everything?
Yes, I must.
You know, you look great with a melting candle on your forehead.
You would.
I can see that you're not taking me very seriously.
I'm not.
No, I am, really.
Really? That must be where you scream in terror.
I don't want to scream in terror.
Oh.
Can't you feel my terror? Sorry, we're stuck in
Twitter. Why do you yell and always laugh so much?
I wasn't laughing about anything in particular. Somewhere there's a fish nibbling on my foot and really tickles.
Awkward.
You're about as fearsome as a doorstop.
Is it a really evil-looking doorstop?
No.
Never mind.
How can you see without eyes?
How can you walk around without a brain? Some things no one can answer.
He has a brain, I suppose.
Was your mother's father bald, too?
I'm not bald. I'm not. I don't really have either, Pete.
You're a skull, therefore you're bald.
Well, at least now you never have to worry about what to wear.
Well, I suppose that's true.
Yeah, it's definitely really easy.
It is.
That's also true. And I feel good in hat.
You're wonderful in hat.
I'm going now.
Good. Now, leave me alone.
But
I'm not a screaming.
I want you as my sidekick in all games. You must save him at the end of the
hour. Well,
you combined items.
This is so unfair.
I want this. I must have it for my arm.
Hey, that's my arm.
What's my arm now?
Now everybody's going to storm the fortress, but I'm going to be stuck here.
You poor baby. I came back as arm.
If I gave you your arm back, what would you do with it?
I terrorize the South Sea. I torture the living.
Uh-huh.
I demolish those
who... Really?
What I meant to say was I needed to send you with him.
Nope.
No, I don't believe you.
The rotten.
No. He'd just use it for evil.
He would. But he's delightful evil. Well, let's cut this evil rope.
Ha-ha! It's cold steel, people call this thing rope.
Yeah. Now, let's do the stupid thing and use the cannon. You know why we have carrying straight rope?
With the demon flame.
We're about to find out.
Cannonballs. I'll blast my significant other into the significance of a world. I don't know how much I can reach her.
That's why we have carrying straight rope.
Not too stable. That was a close one.
Oh, yes. Top dies he goes. Oh no.
Oh, she's devastated.
No, I'm gonna look at the sword. No, sir.
I wouldn't be able to swim with all that treasure.
I'll leave it here and come back for it when I have a boat.
No, take the treasure.
I'll leave it here and come back for it when I have a boat. It's the biggest pile of treasure I've ever seen.
Because the ship is capsized, this ladder goes from nowhere.
Okay.
I don't even want to know what Lestat's plans were for that.
Well, he's in the bathtub. Let's take it.
No self-respecting pirate would be seen wearing that.
No self-respecting pirate. Okay, let's take that.
I hate to think what that comb is going through.
It's unused. Take it.
I think Lestat needs it more than I do.
He's dead, he doesn't care. What's it going to be?
Marry me or die. That thing.
Seems creepy.
I don't know. That seems kind of creepy.
It is kind of creepy.
It's got a zombie ballerina.
How cute. Let's take it.
It got broken when the ship capsized.
But you won't let me take anything, Gabra.
Chocolate covered barnacles, marshmallow hooks, creation, glass eyes. Yeah.
Take it.
It's with Chuck and all his glory.
Glory.
You got it the first time. Ooh, a leather collection.
Hey, it's the Songs for Undead Lovers collection.
Let's take them.
I have no place to plug them in.
There's a leather collection. There we go. Let's take that.
Now, my hi-fi is broken. It's impossible to find a quadraphonic needle anywhere in the Caribbean.
Yeah, it's really hard when you're about to paradise.
A beautiful high-capacity washer and dryer combination.
The Caribbean?
It's a bag of wooden nickels. Some treasure.
Let's take it.
Hey, there's a big diamond ring behind this bag.
Mmm.
It's a diamond ring.
I'm sure it's not.
Huh.
Or anything.
This bag of nickels feels light.
Well, this is an interesting solution that you'd only figure out well if you knew the properties of diamonds. Yes, I do. How is this out of that hole? I don't know. No, it's somebody else. It looks exactly like him.
I've been forever. Is it really you?
Unfortunately.
Did you really mean what you said out there?
He lied.
You ever lied?
Lied. Well, yes, I brush. Yes, I did.
Elaine, I'm a man of action. A swashbuckler. A rogue. A wanderer. A man who could hold his breath for 10 minutes.
You can.
No powers and no regrets. I sail with the wind and go where adventure takes me. But somehow something always...
Barbara, stop babbling.
Poor Barbara.
Will you marry me?
With this giant ring that I did not steal from,
Wally? You're alive! But how did you survive the explosion?
Careful.
Oh, it's very clear. I'm just lucky I wasn't wearing my seatbelt. Wow, Elaine!
No comment.
Some ring!
Thank you, Wally. It's me, Jason, from Diver.
Hey, that looks just like a big diamond ring that Chuck had in his treasure hole. You know, the one with that ghastly, disfiguring voodoo curse on it. Well, I'm sure Diver couldn't have been in that ring.
What's that?
I've got to be going. I hear there's a tattoo ring that's taken from his island at Russell's time. Here's the money!
Diver!
Been turned to gold. How could the girl still work? A girlfriend's gold.
Oh no. Really?
Well, she's not going to be happy about this.
Really pissed about this.
It's Elaine. I've got to change her back somehow.
Let's hide her.
She must weigh a ton. No offense. Hey, I wonder how many carrots she... No, bad idea. Elaine? Honey? You okay? Can I guess anything? I'll just start licking that pirate face then, huh?
Yeah, you better get on now. Let's take this. It is a plaque. Let's read it.
It's an informative plaque put up by the Plunder Island Naturalist Society. Plunder Island Seal Chicken. One of Plunder Island's most common fauna and the animal
but
which are...
But how do we get the chicken to stay still?
I don't think so. Do you know any rising pirate stories?
Wait, guys. This way looks promising. Not scary and dark and evil. Not whatever it has in sticks of me evil. Let's go this way. Hello, small pirate.
You've got to help me. We're closed. You've got to help. I
closed?
Yep. The child labor laws around here are very strict.
Very
strict. But my girlfriend was placed into a pirate curse.
A pirate curse?
You need to see the lady over in Plunder Swamp. She's been leaving flowers around. You might find one somewhere here in town.
Thank you. You've been most helpful. There's a flower right there.
Feeling down because your chips turned to gold?
Obviously.
It's your fortune told. Voodoo and things. Formerly just voodoo. Visit our new location on Plunder Island.
Huh. There always seems to be a voodoo shop where we are. Odd. Really odd. It looks like... a voodoo place needs this. Oh, a voodoo person is in here. I'm
sorry. Oh, it's you again.
That's the most terrifying image of evil.
Not really.
I bring you warning from the infernal realm. Do not go farther into the swamp.
Why?
Turn back. Turn back. Darkness will envelop you.
How did you get all the way up there?
How did you?
Through sheer force of will.
All right, there was a bunch of those weird voodoo people. They found me on shore and put me on top of this plaque all the time, thinking they were so funny.
Do you need me to hunt you down?
Help! I need no help from you foolish mortals.
I think you will.
The all-powerful demonic star.
Okay, this is a bad idea.
Don't get me wrong, I do appreciate your offer.
What are you doing up there?
I am standing as a testament.
Standing?
Standing as a testament to the power of the forces of evil that will one day claim victory over the entire earth.
Okay. How long are you going to keep doing that?
As long as it takes.
How fun.
Let's get down with it, I suppose.
Never! The powers of darkness are never dull. We will one day prove that. Oh, who might find the fool and hoard out of my stuff?
I hope so.
You seem restless.
Oh, I don't know. It's just that not many people come through this one.
What would you rather be doing?
I need to be out among the lesser people, terrifying them and causing pain and misery.
That would make you happy?
Yes, happy in a dark, demonic way.
Marlamo.
Do you know anything about ripping curses?
Oh, right. I know a lot about missing curses. That's why I'm a disembodied talking skull, sitting on top of a spike in the middle of a swamp.
Don't seem a bit odd.
I'm sorry, it's been a rough day.
I'd love to stay in touch, but I gotta go.
I really can now.
Oh, it looks like it was thrown here by a typhoon.
Or something. We need this haste.
How cute. A paper voodoo doll. I don't need it. It's just a toy.
What a relief. I'm sure it won't do anything. After all, it's just a paper voodoo doll.
Yep, it's paper.
Ooh, my brain!
How many times can we be evil?
Ooh, my brain!
That's all he says. Yes, we do. We also want some.
Wow, I got a whole pack of gum.
Let's see, what type of gum do we get?
Put old jerky bubble gum.
Let's see.
Like sirloin.
Sirloin. Let's pull this time.
Nice place. I love what you've done with it.
Thank you. You'll have to excuse the me. The kids came over to play with their paper voodoo dolls.
Ah.
They're adorable children. Would you like to see some pictures?
Yeah.
Perhaps later. Yes, there is no time for that now. I think that
I don't know what has happened. You've been killed.
Hey, yes. Good. Something terrible has happened. I finally proposed to Elaine.
Congratulations. That doesn't sound so good.
And when I placed the engagement ring on her hand, she was placed under a horrible pile of curse and trapped for eternity as a solid gold statue.
That is bad.
Strange. I was struck with a wave of overwhelming hatred and anger.
Yeah, that was such as a pretty mean guy.
I was talking about Elaine.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
We don't have to worry about that now. We have to hurry.
Do not panic, Barbara. She will be safe until we can break the curse.
Then
we have to worry about her being stolen. Where did you hide her?
I just remembered something. I've got to go.
You did remember to hide the giant solid gold statue of your girlfriend from all the other pirates on the island?
No, we were sort of left her on the beach.
Hurry, before you're too late.
Oh, it's too late. Look at me at the clock.
I've got to get her back. This is so embarrassing.
Yeah, it is.
I think I'm going to need some more help.
What do you mean I have help, Barbara?
Someone's stolen Elaine.
That is unfortunate.
Very unfortunate.
It would be difficult to get her back.
Very difficult.
You know who kidnapped her?
Not for certain, but I suspect that it's the mangy pirate anchored in Danger Cove.
So why are you calling the mangy?
Did you need something to lift the curse?
No, LeChuck's curse is a very powerful one. Fueled by his anger and his intense frustration in dealing with the opposite sex, I have nothing here to lift so powerful a curse.
Lie!
One way.
Great, tell me.
You have to replace the curse ring with a pure one of greater or equal value. A good guideline is 2 months out.
I'm a pirate. I don't make a salary.
Where am I going to find a huge, uncursed diamond ring?
There's a question.
A piece of a whopping big diamond ring on Blood Island.
Oh, yeah, that's a good place I want to go.
Mm-hmm. I've never heard of it.
You will soon become quite familiar with it. But you must be careful, Guybrush. I have foreseen that your journey will be filled with peril and deception. I have also seen that Blood Island will be the place where you will die.
But I don't want to go there.
Are you saying this is the place I should go? What are you, nuts?
Yeah. The value of the ring on Blood Island comes from its emotional significance. It represents a pure, true love, a power greater than any other.
Oh, that's sweet. I think I'm coming in my eyes.
Do not mock the voodoo priestess.
I'm a music player.
How will I find the ring on Blood Island?
All I can say is that I see a long and painful history connected with that ring. And I feel a great sadness associated with it. You will learn more once you have actually found the island.
How do I get that?
You will need three things.
A little?
A map to Blood Island, for the journey is a long and dangerous one.
Yeah.
A seaworthy ship to take you there.
I'll skip.
Not skip and crew. Got it. Blood Island, here I come. I finally defeated LeChuck and his skeleton pirate.
Not really. Dublock.
Destroyed completely.
But I heard him blow up and everything.
You'd be surprised at how much abuse and evil undead zombie pirates can do.
Is this true?
I finally found Big Warp and was enormously disappointed.
Big Warp, yeah. Pure evil. You were lucky to escape alive.
I can't remember much about it. Just that I was expecting so much more and felt so let down.
Yes, it is the source of much of LeChuck's power.
And I'm never going back there again.
I have foreseen otherwise. You will return to Big Warp and
I don't want to go back to Big Warp.
Once again.
What makes you think the check will be there?
Yeah.
Some men can search their entire lives and never discover their reason for being. The check was found here. To perpetually rise from the dead and torment you and Elaine. It's what he does best.
It really is.
Well, it's kind of hard to string that out of him. Well, how can I finally destroy him for good?
No one knows. His power seems to grow with every incarnation.
What is that?
We have dealt with him for now, but this respite can only be temporary at best.
What island is this, anyway?
Yeah.
You have landed on Thunder Island.
It's a thing?
Thunder Island. Sounds appropriately piratey.
Very piratey.
It's a sort of retirement community for ex-pirates and their spouses.
Live long enough to become a pirate?
All too much excitement on the island. All centering around Governor Marley, the Chuck, and a giant chicken.
What?
What about this
giant chicken?
Ah, yes, Sabra. You have landed on an island gripped by the cold, clammy hand of fear.
Don't you think you're being a bit overdramatic?
Just a little bit.
Until the great beast landed on our shores.
The great beast?
Some people were sent to make the islanders pay for their cruelty. Others claim it was simply blind faith. Whatever the entity. It came.
What was it?
A giant chicken?
It was El
Pollo Diablo.
The giant demon chicken. Tall as a man, and twice as powerful. His massive drumsticks propel him through the dark jungle of
a giant chicken.
The beast, but on the eve of the full moon, his blood-curdling squawk.
I'm not going to believe him, though.
This wretched island.
This wretched island.
Here's the squawk. Waiting.
for the one day.
No, wait. Don't tell me.
Let me go. This is the point that El Pollo Diablo was going to be a much bigger part of the game. But as we shall see, we don't really see El Pollo Diablo.
He's hatching a diabolical plan.
He roams the island.
He's not impressed with us. He's never impressed with us. Would you be impressed with him? His cool coat and beard is gone. I like his cool coat.
Skeptical to the true nature of the beast. They're all dead now. Pecked into a bloody pulp by his savage beast.
Well,
but I'm sure you have nothing to worry about.
Yeah, right, whatever. Elaine is governor of this island, too?
No, I don't. He's a governor of a lot of islands.
The tri-island area, comprised of Melee, Booty, and Plunder Islands. She moved to her fort here on Plunder after the kitchen and landscaping staff quit her Booty Island mansion.
Is there something to do with that? How is he good here?
I realized that my location in the swamp on Crab Island wasn't ideal.
It wasn't.
So you moved to a swamp on a different island?
I just said I could see the future. I never claimed to be an expert in real estate.
You really aren't.
I've heard all I needed to know.
And I'm going to stop skating today. Thank you for everybody who came out to watch the skating. Is exactly one person, but thanks, and I will